Welcome back students. In the class MMSC second geography, the course title is watershed management. Today we will discuss about the concept of watershed management. Friends, in the previous lecture we had discussed about the definition of watershed, major parts of watershed, then concept of watershed, and today we will discuss about the third topic of this first unit, that is watershed management. Friends, before starting the discussion on watershed management, you should remember about what are the elements of watershed and what is the definition of watershed. Once you understood the definition and concept of watershed, so it will be very easy to understand the management concept also. Here the definition of watershed is given. There are two watershed definitions, and between these two watershed definition some common words are there. If you look at the first definition, so watershed is defined the planning and practice of soil, water and vegetation conservation measures for sustainable development. Means what? For the sustainable development of watershed, planning and practice of these three resources, soil resources, water resources and vegetation resources, its conservation measures planning is a part of watershed management. In short, the watershed management means the planning and practice of soil, water and vegetation conservation measures for sustainable development. In another definition, it is explained that the management of watershed includes sustainable use of natural resources with participatory approach of peoples, institutions within the watershed ecosystem. The second definition, participatory approach is included, but the common words is soil, water and vegetation, and in another definition it is used as a natural resources. So natural resources included soil, water and vegetation. So in both definition, conservation measures planning is included for sustainable development, but in the second definition they included participatory approach. Means while the implementation of watershed management conservation measures in the field, the local people's participation is very essential. Again, sometimes governmental and non-governmental institution is also part of participation for the watershed management. So therefore we can define watershed management means the planning and practice of soil, water and vegetation conservation measures for sustainable development, or watershed management is the sustainable use of natural resources with participatory approach of peoples, institution within the watershed ecosystem. Here three natural resources have been shown, which are the major components of watershed management. The first component is land and soil. If you consider any watershed, that time its geographical area means land and soil, so both are common, but soil resources study its chemical, physical and hydrological properties is also essential for the land use planning. So therefore land or soil is first component of watershed management. The second component, water. Water is life, and in the conservation planning of any watershed, water is prime part. Whereas the surface runoff should be converted into small ponds or into different conservation water conservation measures, and from this the groundwater level should be increased. So solution of water scarcity problem is prime objective of watershed management, any watershed management. And the third component of watershed management is biome or vegetation. It includes forest, plant, trees, etc. So while these three components of watershed we conserve or develop, it is a part of sustainable development of any watershed. So these are the three major watershed management components: land, water, and biome. Here, as per Garg and Vani, they define that watershed is not simply the hydrological unit, but it is a social, political, and ecological entity which plays a crucial role in determining the food, social, and economical security, and it provides life support services to rural people. If we consider the people which living in the watershed area, especially rural people, so for its life support services, for providing economical security and social security, watershed management is also essential. And watershed is not a geographical unit, but it is a social ecological entity. Whereas this socio-economical aspect of rural people should be considered while watershed management plan prepare or develop. Now, again, in the concept of watershed management, some another concepts are included. The first, watershed management involves consumption of land, water, and forest natural resources in the particular area. The watershed management helps to reduce and solve the various geo-environmental problems such as the drought problem, flood problem, or soil erosion problem. So to reduce this problem or to solve this problem, the management of watershed is essential. The third concept, it includes alternative land use planning for resource utilization. Suppose if we consider any single watershed, the current land use planning or land use aspect should be converted into utilization of land resources or planning of land use in that particular area. Suppose fallow land is there, so using different techniques, conservation measures, fallow land should be converted into forest land, fallow land should be converted into agricultural land. So on the basis of soil characteristics and the present land use, watershed management land use plan should be prepared. And finally, with the integration of these three resources, land, water, and biome, the planning of consumption and preparation of watershed management policy should be implemented with the help of local people's participation. So participatory approach is very essential in the watershed management, because watershed management, it's not only solve the geo-environmental problem, but it also solve the socio-economical problem, and it also includes socio-economical condition of rural people. Now, in this slide, you can see the steps of watershed management. So, in the previous slide, you have been seen the major concept of watershed management. After considering all these phenomena, concept of watershed management, what are the steps of watershed management? So, look at this slide. First, we need to define the objectives of watershed management. It is the first step of watershed management. Why we started the management of watershed? What is the major aim and what are the major objectives? That objective we need to define very clearly, and on the basis of this objective, we can prepare plan, method, and on the basis of this method, we can come to the separate conclusion, planning, monitoring, and implementation policy. The next second step in the watershed management is to understand a study of watershed as a system, because watershed is a complex system. It is geo-environmental entity, it is a geo ecosystem, or watershed is a separate ecosystem. So considering all these phenomena, watershed as a system is need to study and understand. After this, need to select a watershed for management and implementation of different policy. So on the basis of expert opinion or on the basis of prioritization, we can select a watershed. Then the study of selected watershed is essential. It includes study of watershed characteristics, linear characteristics, aerial characteristics, relief characteristics, socio-economical characteristics. All aspects of that watershed need to study in details for further planning and process. After study of watershed characteristics, need to collect various types of database for the watershed management, considering relief database, maps, statistical information, population database, socio-economical database, then geomorphological aspect, climatological aspects. All required database should be collected for the preparation of project, and collected data should be analyzed, maps, and finally prepare the report on the basis of data analysis and its mapping is the another step of watershed management. So this is the first major section of watershed management. It includes laboratory as well as field-based work also. And after the preparation of report, on the basis of this, integrated watershed development program of that particular selected watershed should be prepared, and it should be defined very clearly the prioritization, preparation, and components of watershed treatment plan of that selected watershed. And with the help of local people's participation, integrated watershed development program should be started. And after implementing of this participatory integrated watershed development program, continuous monitoring and evaluation is also required. And on the basis of monitoring and evaluation, the lacunas should be removed and try to develop a whole ecosystem as well for the socio-economic development of people and geo-environmental sustainable conservation measures in particular of that watershed. So this is the cycle of watershed management or steps of any watershed management. Thank you.